Greetings everyone. My topic for discussion is ultrasound and MRI findings of tennis leg. Tennis leg is very common entry of a painful calf region. Tennis leg is caused by rupture of medial head of gastrocnemius muscle, usually at its distal musculotendinous junction or myotendinous junction. However, tevers in this muscle and its tendon are all included in the common term tennis leg. It is commonly seen in clinical practice and results in painful calf. And the USG and MRI are common modalities to detect the regions of tear in the calf muscles. The ultrasound findings are most commonly include disruption of the pinnate pattern of the distal musculotendinous junction of gastrocnemius, mostly at the triceps surae and fluid dragging along the fascia. MRI findings typically includes the high T2 signal intensity deep to the medial head of gastrocnemius. Tennis leg is fairly common clinical condition first described by Powell in 1883. It is not restricted to tennis players as its name suggests tennis leg. However, it has higher incidence in tennis players and typical clinical presentation is a sports-related acute pain in the middle portion of calf associated with snapping sensation. And it is commonly an avulsion type of injury and it's a common cause of painful calf. Most commonly injury pattern in the tennis leg is the injury to medial head of gastrocnemius solis or plantaris. Plantaris rupture was once thought to be the most common cause of tennis leg, but on subsequent surgical and autopsy studies, it reveals that the most common lesion is the avulsion injury of gastrocnemius, particularly the medial head of gastrocnemius. It is commonly associated with solis injury. Injuries to the gastrocnemius and solis generally are more severe and require longer time to heal. Therefore, it's clinically very important to differentiate between the plantaris rupture from the other calf muscle injuries. I am presenting the index case of a 37-year male referred to our department with a chief complaint of pain in the right calf while doing gym since 2 days. For calf muscles pathologies like tennis leg, we have to be very familiar with the anatomy of the calf muscles. There are superficial and deep muscle groups in the posterior compartment of leg. Gastrocnemius solis and plantaris compromise the superficial muscular group, while the deep crural group includes tibialis posterior, flexor hallucis longus, flexor deltoid longus. The medial head of gastrocnemius has its origin from the posterior spectrum medial femoral condyle, while the lateral head originates from the lateral femoral condyle. Distally, these two heads merge together as one. Further distally, it forms the Achilles tendon by merging with soleus, and its tendon, the origin of soleus, is from the back of head of fibula and upper one-third of posterior surface of fibula and middle one-third of medial border of tibia. The plantaris tendon is a vestigial muscle, as we all know, and is visualized between the medial head of gastrocnemius and soleus. It originates at a position superior and medial to the lateral head of gastrocnemius muscle and further travels deep to the lateral head of gastrocnemius. The tendon of plantaris is situated between the medial head of gastrocnemius and soleus muscle. It has its insertion either anterior, medially on Achilles or onto the posterior surface of calcaneus. Microscopically talking, the most common fibers are the type 2, which are fast switch fibers, are found in these calf muscles. The gastrocnemius plantaris muscles are overstretched in tennis leg when one does dorsiflexion of ankle with the knee in full extension. That is the biomechanics. This results in simultaneous active contraction and passive stretching of gastrocnemius and plantaris, causing its injury. On imaging, it's a very simple thing to know. As we all know, the tear presents as an anechoic fluid collection. And in this image, as we all know, the USG shows partial rupture of medial head of gastrocnemius. How it will present as an anechoic fluid collection between the medial head of gastrocnemius muscle at its musculotendinous junction, indicated by local disruption of muscle fibers. Here we can see the fluid is seen tracking between the aponeurosa medial head of gastrocnemius, this one, aponeurosa medial head of gastrocnemius and soleus muscle, most prominent at the level of musculotendinous junction. On MRI, as we all know, how tears presents, tear presents as a high T2 signal intensity fluid area. So focal areas of disruptions are seen. Here we can see a focal area of disruption presenting as a high T2 signal intensity of medial head of gastrocnemius muscle close to its distal musculotendinous junction adjacent to triceps surae. Here we can see the outer one is medial head of gastrocnemius, this one is soleus, and fluid is seen tracking in between them, and it's indicating a tear. Tennis leg, it's quite common clinical condition underlying acute painful cough. It is ascribed to rupture of medial head of gastrocnemius. Most commonly involved is the medial head of gastrocnemius only. It typically occurs due to the overstretching of muscle by dorsiflexion of ankle with the knee in full extension. This condition tends to frequently occur in middle-aged, poorly conditioned patient. Again, in strenuous physical activity like gym, sudden onset of pain in the calf, and the patient often complains of an audible snap or palpable pop. Most patients coming to the hospital because of this condition has developed significant pain and swelling during the first 24 hours and significantly impairing their daily activity. And late complications can occur like muscle herniation, myositis ossificans, contractures, scarring, functional impairment, and so on. The imaging modalities are very important to differentiate this entity from other important causes of painful cough like ruptured Baker cyst, deep venous thrombosis, pyomyositis, abscess, or compartment syndrome. Imaging, as we all know, on USG, it will present as anechoic area of fluid, which represents tear between the medial head of gastrocnemius and soleus and triceps surae. On MRI, how tear presents? High signal intensity. You have to look for high signal intensity. And MRI provides a more global view. USG is a cheap investigation. We all know it's readily available. And it's a first degree of investigation, first line of investigation. But MRI provides more global view and better view of injuries, especially the muscles apart from gastrocnemius. So MRI, we have to keep in mind high T2 signal intensity fluid between medial head of gastrocnemius and soleus muscle, and also look for other muscle injuries in the posterior compartment of calf muscle. Thank you very much.